is up? It is the anonymous sneakerhead, the most mysterious sneaker YouTuber in the game, back with another video for you guys today, man. And in today's video, I have another episode of Sneaker Talk. And in this episode, I'm going to be talking about the upcoming releases for the month of April, today being April 1st. You know what I'm saying? For those of you that are new here, make sure that you go ahead, hit that subscribe button, join the anonymous sneakerhead family, join the channel. Also, take the time to go ahead and smash that like button. It really helps with the algorithms, helps bring more people to the videos, which can help grow the channel. And last but not least, take the time to go ahead and follow the Instagram at Anonymous Sneakerhead. You get a lot of information up there, first poll stories, questions, all of that fun stuff. Now, let's get into this video real quick. I was hoping that by yesterday, obviously yesterday being the last day of Air Max month, I was hoping by then my Air Max 90 Bacons or the Vapor Max Evolutions that I got would be in. I got the, because they restocked with all the like hype beastie Air Max pieces on there and the what the situation. So neither of those got in yet. But when they get in, you guys will get reviews of those. But without further ado, let's get into upcoming April releases. So to start it off, man, just tomorrow, and I'm doing all brands here, but to start it off tomorrow, we are getting the Reebok Kamikaze 2 Digital Glow. Now, these are really, really interesting to me. Those of you who have been around the channel know that the Reebok Kamikaze 2 is my single favorite sneaker silhouette. And this colorway actually reminds me a little bit of these, which is a grail of mine that I'm super happy to have. But color palette just reminds me a little bit of these. Obviously, it's a little bit darker. You know what I'm saying? And those actually are releasing, I guess, in like a, I don't want to call it a pack because you don't buy them together, but I guess a collection with an Instapump Fury. Next, on April 3rd, we are getting the Air Jordan 12 Low Easter. Now, you guys know why the Jordan 12 Low, if you've been around the channel, you know why the Jordan 12 Low is an important silhouette to me. But I promise that if I did hit on the Super Bowl 12 Lows, then I will not be going for the Easter 12 Lows. So I'm gonna let those pass. However, the packaging on them is really, really dope. You get your regular Jordan 12 box with like an Easter egg on it, and then like grass, like the egg is being hidden on the inside. Really, really dope concept to me. Then moving along, coming in on April 6th, we are getting the Air Max 95 LeBron James colorway. I don't know if I'm gonna go for these, to be honest with y'all, man. It's dope. It's a dope concept. I just don't like the colorway of it. Like, I wish it was just the purple shoe or just the yellow shoe. So I don't think I'm gonna be going for them. What I do like, though, I'm not gonna lie, what I do really like about them is how, like, on the bottom of the Air Max 95, where it usually says like the pounds per square inch in each pod or whatever, it has like LeBron James accomplishments on the bottom, which is pretty cool. It's similar to the Jordan 10 and how the Jordan 10 had Jordan accomplishments up to that point in his career on there. So that's pretty dope. Moving forward, again, just really quickly want to mention these because I know some people do like these. I personally have not bought a pair yet, but we do have the Air Jordan 35 Smoke Gray coming out, which it does look pretty cool. That little heel collar that they got going on with the neutral materials does look pretty interesting. But that's all I'm gonna say about that, because the next shoe coming up is the one that a lot of people are super excited about, and that is on April 10th, we are supposed to be getting the Air Jordan 5 Raging Bull, or the Toro Bravo as it's listed on the sneakers app. Now, me personally, I don't need this shoe. I'm gonna try to get it for a video and then flip it, to be 100% honest with you. This isn't a sneaker that I personally need. I don't really have a connection to it like a lot of other people do have a connection to it, but I would like to bring a video for you guys down the line. So hopefully I could get it for the video and then get rid of them. But like I said, I personally don't really need this shoe. Now, moving on to April 16th, we have a sneaker that I'm gonna be going for, not because I want this sneaker, but because I want another sneaker, and that is the Air Griffey Max in the Royal colorway. Now, I love Griffeys, you know what I'm saying? Growing up, for me, it was the biggest shoe in like elementary and middle school. Everybody had one except for me. I never had one, but I really, really want the freshwater colorway. And those are, I should have just bought them when the resale on them was 260. I couldn't get them that day in the release because of work. So I wasn't able to like put in any footwork or anything to actually go pick them up for retail. But now they are reselling on the Godat for $380 in my size, and I'm just not gonna spend that money for some Griffey. So hopefully I could get these Royals and flip them or potentially trade them for a pair of the Freshwaters. Also, there is, I don't know when the release date is gonna be on these, but there have been images leaked of a Jackie Robinson Griffey where it's the number 42 instead of 24, and like Jackie Robinson quotes or stat lines on there, which I think is pretty interesting. So don't know when those are coming out though, so those aren't officially on this list. moving forward, on April 23rd, we are getting another Reebok Kamikaze 2. Once again, my favorite sneaker silhouette of all time. But this one is a Candyland colorway. And, you know what I'm saying? I love the Reebok Kamikaze 2. I do. I have, let me count. I got them all over here. So I got this one, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 pairs of Reebok Kamikaze 2s. You know what I'm saying? So I absolutely love them. But this colorway, I'm not feeling it. Once again, those of you guys that know me know I'm not the biggest patent leather guy, especially when it's all over a shoe, you know what I'm saying? So they just flooded this shoe in patent leather, a bunch of different colors. Now, the color scheme is cool. I would like it more if it was like regular leather and suede, like a mixture, kind of like this shoe. Like, you get your suede, your regular leather, like a different type of, like, I don't even know what this material is, but yeah, something a little different, man. Now, moving forward one more day, on the 24th, we are getting the Air Jordan 11 Low Columbia. Now, a lot of people are going to love this shoe. It's going to be a huge shoe for the summer. Me personally, once again, I just told you guys about patent leather. Not the biggest patent leather guy, even if it comes to 11s. I have two pairs of 11s that I keep in my collection. Those are the Bred 11s and the Jubilees. Have not worn either one of them. But every other Jordan 11 I've had, I sold. Even the lows, I had the Jordan 11 Low Golds, and I sold those for way less than they're worth way back then. But it is what it is, you know what I'm saying? But you know what I'm saying? I'm going to have to pass on those. Once again, the Low Columbias. Once again, hopefully I could get them for you guys and maybe do a review. And also, on the 24th, we are getting the Ama Menier 3s. Now, these are fire to me. These are fire. Call it hype beastie, call it whatever you want. These are absolutely fire to me. A nice, clean, kind of vintage-looking Jordan 3. Looks like we get some premium materials around in the sock liner. Got that nice little, like, purple hit going around the heel of the midsole. No cement print, just suede where the cement print would be. These are dope to me. They're going to be super hard to get. I'm not going to say I'm going to get them for sure. Retail on them, or resell on them, is going to be crazy. But I will definitely be trying to get them. And then, last but not least, I want to end this video off, or at least this list off, with a shoe that I can guarantee you guys that I will get my hands on. And that is, on April 28th, we are getting the Air Jordan 4 UNC. How is it that I can guarantee you guys that I'm getting my hands on them? And that is because I got these for retail right here, which I personally don't care about. But I know a lot of you watching do care about them, and a lot of people in the sneaker game do really care about these. And the resale price tells me that. Me personally, don't care about these too much. My whole plan, if you guys fall back all the way to the end of 2020, I was saying I'm gonna try to get these first. Hopefully I could get them for retail. And I'm gonna use this as trade bait for the UNC 4s if I don't get the UNC 4s for retail. So if I get the UNC 4s for retail, then these will stay around. I'll probably never wear them. That's why they're not in the drop fronts behind me. Like, I'll probably never wear these. Even if I do get the UNC 4s, but the main reason why these are dead stock right now, I can't say I'll never wear them, I probably will, but the main reason why these are dead stock right now is because of these UNC 4s coming out. To me, the UNC 4s beat these any single day, and I know that I can sell these if I don't hit for retail and get the money to go pick up the UNC 4s for resale. So this right here is the UNC 4. I'm showing you guys my UNC 4 right now. This is it in my hand. I already have my pair. And that is it for April releases. Now, obviously things can change. This is everything that was on Kicks on Fire. We know things get pushed back, move forward. I wouldn't be surprised if, you know what I'm saying, we're supposed to be seeing those Jordan 1 patinas like at the beginning of May. I wouldn't be surprised if we maybe get a shop drop of them at the end of April, or maybe they even just get pushed up to April altogether. And also, I pulled this shoe out right here. I think we may be getting a US release of these. I know not too many people are looking for them. You know what I'm saying? Everyone's going to act like they love them as soon as they come up on Sneakers app or whatever it is, but not many people have been talking about them. The popcorn ones did come out recently, and when the overseas release happened, so these released overseas already in Asia and Europe, which is how I got my pair. When the overseas release happened, the popcorns released overseas about a month before these released overseas. So that's why I'm just guessing that these are probably gonna release next month, just because the popcorns released last month. And if it's going on the same release schedule, just push back as it was overseas, we could potentially get these. Also, the fact that we do get the SP, the spring 21 on there. April is like the quintessential spring month. Like, when you think of spring, you think of April. You don't think of the end of March or May, you think of April when someone says spring. So potentially these could be coming out this month. But that is it for this video, you guys. I am the most mysterious sneaker YouTuber in the game. Let me know what you guys think down below in the comments. What are you looking forward to? Also, if you're new here, make sure that you go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Join the Anonymous Sneakerhead family. Join the channel. Also, take the 2 seconds to go ahead and smash that like button. Really helps with the algorithms, helps bring more people to the channel. And last but not least, go ahead and follow the Instagram at Anonymous Sneakerhead. You get a lot of information up there for his poll stories, questions, kicks of the day, all of that fun stuff. But that is it for this one, you guys. I am the most mysterious sneaker YouTuber in the game. And as always, it's all about the sneakers.